Hey folks, this is Ben Gessel. How's it going? This is going to be kind of a general vlog, but it will be something, a few things I'll be talking about here in particular with this video. So I visited, my dad's in not too bad of shape right now. My dad just has pancreatitis, and so he was in a little bit worse shape a few weeks ago. He's doing better now. But there's a whole bunch of things, of course, that were going on. One of my younger brothers and my sister was there. And anyway, my mom and of course, we were chatting with my dad to the extent that my dad could chat, and he was doing fine. I can't explain to you how weird it is to have a parent, though, one of my parents who's having some troubles this way, even if it's not especially serious. In this case, it's in the moderate range, so I'm not too worried. But everybody's a little different, and I'm very close to my parents, and I want my parents to be alive for a lot longer, you know, of course. So it was hard for me to see my dad not be able to have solid foods. He's being fed intravenously, but at least he's getting all the nutrients he needs. But there's also a lot of complications with this with pancreatitis involving liquids and things. So there was, I'm sorry. I can get into it more. I understand it more. I just don't know how interested you guys are in all the details about pancreatitis. But there's so many things I don't fully understand. But you can't really function normally in terms of urination. You have to get a tube to get waste out of your body that way. And otherwise, so it's because your pancreas isn't working. And stuff. And anyway, so aside from all that kind of train of thought, and I'm also going to be visiting him, my dad, tomorrow. I mean, like, you know, as you could probably guess, I'm like, why my dad? Why not me? I would go through anything. I'd put myself in my dad's shoes. Make me go through the pain, not my dad, you know. That these are my thoughts of this entire time, like last week or two. And my mom has been telling me that my dad's been doing fine, so I haven't been too much of a wreck, you know. But I just felt powerless. I felt like I couldn't. What can you know? Not a whole lot I could do, and you know. Anyway, so different subject here a little bit. I don't know. But the main thing is, the main good news is my dad is doing better. He won't be in the hospital too much longer, you know. But it's going to need to be kind of a gradually getting better kind of thing. So, my dad, though, today, this is one of the first. Like, I think he had something yesterday or something for the first time, actual food, but he tried having some tomato soup and peppermint herbal tea or something like that, and a little bit of chocolate pudding for dessert. It was hard not to it's hard to see that, you know, he couldn't have, you know, vegetables and rice, bread or meat, fruit. It wasn't like he was able to have regular food. It was all liquidy stuff. And so I'm looking forward to when he can have regular food again. It may be, you know, I don't know. I did have a train of thought that was more, I guess you could say, food or health oriented, but I don't know. I think I'm going to sum it up by just saying this. I think a lot of times we just don't think when our organs are functioning properly, we probably aren't always thinking about how is this food that isn't going to kill me, right? Or how is this food that's actually healthy? What does it have in it that helping my body, but also what does it have in it that isn't helping my body? But maybe we don't think about that enough. But the thing that we need to, like, it's like, trying to think of what, how to put this. It's just that maybe the main train of thought here is that simple foods are good to keep, are good to good habit to make a, it's good to, it's the right idea to make a habit of eating simple plant foods in general, because your organs will thank you. But my dad has always been so healthy in this regard. My mom, so when we don't, we've all agreed that it's not my diet. It's not my dad's diet that caused this. It's something problem, something different. So some things you just can't control, but it's probably a good idea, basically, to not have fried chicken every night, if that makes sense, or every day. But there's something else I have to mention here. Oh gosh. Sorry, folks. Just training, kind of switching thoughts here a little bit. I don't know, always know what to say, by the way, with these kinds of things in general. When you feel very emotional, I think I know what I'm about to finish up here on, here on. I might have, need to have some dinner here in a second. I don't always know. So, obviously funerals are one kind of situation where even if someone's extremely close to your family, you're probably going to just be in tears. You can't say hardly anything or whatever. Or it's going to be like, So you're just kind of not really all physically present, mentally present. I mean, you're not all mentally, emotionally present. You're kind of in shock still, often at a funeral, or if you're at a hospital, or if you're, think of some other kind of really unpleasant experience, not necessarily just like this, but something, could be, there could be a number of things like that. There's a lot of things about a lot of these situations where you don't always know what to say and or how to act or anything, and it depends on the event, I suppose. There are a lot of times where if something bad happens and you know it was your fault, or you had something to do with the reason why it's bad and you feel guilty, or even if it's someone else's fault, or I think there's so many, again, there's so many instances in life, and the, the dating awkwardness and all that stuff too, and being bullied, and anyway, there's all these situations in life we can find ourselves that we don't always know what to say, or we don't always know how to act, or we don't all we always have these thoughts coming through our minds, especially me. I'm one of the people that sometimes has the most, the highest number of thoughts racing through my mind all the time. And that's just the way I am. And So the train of thought I have here, I guess, to finish up some of this video is, which thoughts do you choose to talk about, especially when something unpleasant or emotional is happening? Now, it was very pleasant spending time with my dad. Oh my gosh. The hard part of it was seeing the condition he was in, but he was, again, he's in better shape than he was. Because any one of us are, it's a family, you'd gladly trade places with them, in a heartbeat. I mean, very few exceptions to that. It can't, it's hard to put myself in the position of a person who hates or despises siblings so much that they wouldn't want to see them if they're hurt. But that's a different situation. And it's still something I'm aware of that can happen in some families. But I mean, like, but yeah, pretty much if our sibling or if our parents were in the hospital, we would do everything we could to help them. We don't want them to feel any pain, of course. And if it's the more extreme the pain, we're like morphine or like, oh, that is like don't know. Here's another question for you guys. Is it harder to see a loved one go through pain, like physical pain, or like deep spiritual emotional pain, or what was the thing I was gonna mention? Well, I mean, like, what's hardest to see someone go through? Again, yeah, I think you, I know what it was. It was either physical pain, like very severe pain, or emotional, spiritual pain, or something that's happening, like a disease that's really serious that could lead to death. What's the hardest one to see someone go through? And it's, I don't know. Gosh, I mean, that's a, because in one case, pain is just pain. It's like, oh man, you know, all kinds of pain. There's the other thing is emotional, spiritual pain can be very subtle and ongoing for a long time, and that's a different, whole different game as well, or psychological, whatever. And then, so that, yeah. Physical pain is much more obvious. And then the with diseases and stuff, I haven't really had to deal with anyone in my immediate circle of whatever, you know. Not too many people I've known for a while at least have had like cancer and stuff. I just, what's, yeah, I mean, like I honestly don't know what how to answer that. What's the hardest one to see, to have to see someone go through? I just know that my reactions would be different. My feelings are different. With physical pain, you, it's an immediate, like, I want to do everything I can to make you not feel the pain, and but whatever is going to not be bad for your body. But yeah, so like, let's get the anesthetics big time going on. Or whatever you can do. And then with spiritual emotional pain, you do what you can to help someone, but that's a lot more of a different train of thought. Some things I feel like I can't help with as much, but it's a lot less of a tangible kind of thing, so to speak. It doesn't always involve chemicals so much. But then you get into psychology, but the psychology meets religion, and I don't know. So it's a little bit more complicated in a way. And then you have with diseases that don't cause pain as much, not always, but they are gonna lead to death. You know, gosh, what do you do? You almost, I think with that last case, you definitely want to have a lot of heart to hearts and a lot of doing whatever you can do with that person before they're dead. So that's probably one of the main trains of thought that I think someone might have is, what can I say to this person? What can I do with them? What can we do before it's too late? You know, and so that's probably the gonna be the most emotional one of all three. But debatably, the second one is also really emotional too. The first one, you just, it's really kind of a basic kind of thing. We don't, none of us want to feel physical pain. So before I wrap this guy up, I'm gonna probably make a few other videos maybe tonight. Just very thoughtful. But I maybe had one last memory, and that's with my mom when I was a little boy going to the YMCA with my brother Tom and myself, my mom, and I just. You know, whatever we were doing, whether it was swimming, whether it was gymnastics, whatever it was, I remember going to do that when I was a little boy. And we'd always get something afterward to get, so we weren't super starving when we got home. They always had a little well, kind of a vending machine slash refrigerator there at the YMCA in Tacoma. And I always remember getting something there, and it was just, I loved those times with my brother and my mom. And I would go back there, you know, that's one of the things I miss the most, you know, about when I was younger, is doing that stuff with my family, my mom and my brother. And I imagine with time, those memories will just get more and more dear, you know. But believe me, I wanted to actually stay at the hospital longer and even eat hospital food just to stay with my my family longer, but it was so hard leaving the hospital in a way. And anyway, different kind of video. Sorry, guys. I just had to share some thoughts with you guys. Leave me thoughts and comments below. Catch you guys later. Take care. Bye.